closet, nothing very, very fancy, but this was supposed to be a study. I converted it into my closet, of course. If possible, I can actually store clothes and shoes and makeup in the fridge, in the kitchen, everywhere. So, yeah. Okay, so we'll start with this setup right over here. Of course, it has my entire world hanging on it. Most of my world hanging on it. So I gave my carpenter a reference and he made it from scratch. It cost me about 7 grand, which I don't think is much. It was a good deal because the wood is of a really good quality. It has a lot of space. And so yeah, now whatever clothes you see here, I try and be a little organized and, you know, kind of hang them according to color, silhouettes, type. I try and do that, but then I'm that monster who will ruin the entire setup in the next 2 days. So I stopped trying. So the clothes are hung randomly, turtlenecks, shirts, blazers, a lot of blazers. Over here, you'll see a lot of skirts. Leather skirts, denim skirts, sequin skirts, everything. It has a lot of skirts. Over here, I have my bralettes. You guys would know I'm a big time bralette lover, so I have tons of those. This area right here, this small square box, is my favorite. Over here, I have all my crop tops and t-shirts. Over here, I have all my dresses. It includes all kinds of dresses, mini dresses, mostly maxi dresses, kurta dresses. I have a lot of kurta dresses inside them. Over here, in the bottom shelf, I have all my jeans. I have tons of jeans here, from bell bottoms to skinny jeans to more bell bottoms to more flared pants, mostly flare jeans. I love when my jeans has a good flare. Now over here, I have a few shirts. A tropical print here, again waiting for the summer to wear this. There are some random scarves. Most of my scarves are from Zara. I love their scarves. Over here, this entire lot has my ethnic wear, from kurtas to, you know, ethnic shrugs to dupattas. My current favorite is this entire set. It's a chicken curry kurta set that I got from Lucknow. Oh my god, I love this. I've also done a small 1 minute video on this, on how to wear this in winters and 5 different ways, which you guys should watch. In case you're not following me on Instagram, please go follow me right now. Mention it in the description box. I have another setup. Now this also I got made by my carpenter. I again showed him a good reference. I saw something on Pinterest, I guess, and I got it made. Very, very pretty. It's all wooden. I also use it in a lot of my fashion therapy videos. So yeah, and it mostly has all my jackets, blazers, fur coats, overcoats, a few shrugs here and there, but yeah, mostly blazers. I'm a big time blazer holder. Let's talk about this one. This is a shrug from H&M. I absolutely love it. It is very summery. It has this beautiful print of red, green, whatever. I've tried wearing it in the winters, but it's not very fall appropriate, so I can't wait for summer to come back so I can wear it. This fur coat from H&M that I got, I think last winters. This checkered one, I got this from Sarojini. It's actually an H&M piece. I got this from Sarojini for 200 rupees. People, how cool is that? Okay, this is also a piece from Sarojini. It's very, very smart. I mostly wear it as a dress because it hugs my body so nicely, even though I'm a little too thin, but it really fits me well. And this is my color of the season. I'm obsessed with the color camel, and I got it for 200 rupees. Now if you ask me about my favorite pair, then it has to be this, which is really dirty right now, I'm so sorry, but it's a nude pair of Steve Madden's. These black boots, I really love. They serve me very well. I've already worn them for over a year. I got it, I think, last year. Now then there's a sofa here. This sofa I rented from Filenko. I think I pay about 300 or 350 rupees every month for its rent. And then there's this really pretty plant, a palm here. I love decorating my rooms, my space with plants, because I feel A, they're cheap, B, I don't think there's anything more beautiful than nature. And oh, over here there's a ukulele, jo mujhe bilkul bajana nahi aata hai. Please, I don't know how to play it at all. This is Ravit's. He left for San Francisco, but then he could not take this, so he gave it away. He gave this to me thinking that I'd learn someday, but I'm useless. But yeah, I'll try and learn someday. Okay, now this mirror right here I got from the Banjara market, which is in the sector 56 area of Gurgaon. I got it for 2000 rupees only. Also, the fact that the wood has very worn out paint, and you know, it gives a very vintage feel to the entire room. I love pieces that are very vintagey, raw and rugged looking. Here, there's this, what do I call this? It's like a jute dustbin of sorts that I got from Pepperfry for 456 rupees to be precise. It has all my bags. It has not all my bags, most of the bags that I use frequently. I left most of my bags back home again. I only have bags that I use very often. That's it. And over here, you have a lot of my skincare, a lot of my makeup. I'm not going to talk about it right now because then the video would be really, really long. But to just give you an overview of it, this area has my skincare. This has a lot of my makeup. This has all my perfumes. And now if you want to come down to the shelves, to the drawers, I'll show you what I have in it. This drawer, I have all my base makeup, my foundation, my face powders, rose gold oil and stuff like that, primers and stuff. This big drawer, I have all my lipsticks. Yes, I have too many of them. I'm a big time lipstick holder. So I have all my lipsticks. And in case you're wondering what I'm wearing today, I'm wearing Maybelline's Nude Nuance. I have all my palettes. I have all my highlighters, eyeshadows, and you know, like my blush palettes and stuff. Here, I have my gold jewelry, all my gold earrings. In the drawer next to it, I have my Indian jewelry, a lot of my silver jewelry that I mostly get from Janpat. And I have my hair sprays, dye shampoo, hair oil, stuff like that. You know, all my tassel earrings, these bobbly stuff that I have. Mostly that. Yep. That is it for my closet, people. Yehi tha. I know not the most organized closet you must have seen, but also because it's not too big, I've tried to kind of, you know, squeeze my entire world into it, but I really like it. Whenever I get ready in this room, it's very therapeutic. And yeah, that's about it. Let me know what you think of this video. I hope this wasn't very long and I hope you guys didn't get bored. It's not very difficult to build your own closet. Of course, it's not like Carrie Bradshaw's closet in Sex and the City, but if you have a house and if you have a small room spare in your house, you know, like a study or something, and if it's totally useless, if you're someone like me who doesn't study at all or works on a study table, whatever, you can convert that room into a small little closet. It won't cost a lot and you'll get a larger, bigger space to dress up, get ready, which I think is very important for us women to do in peace. So yeah, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, get notified every day whenever I put up a video, and I'll see you next time. Bye.